I'm Dr. Kishore. I'm consultant nephrologist and renal transplant physician at PACE Hospitals, Hitech City and Madinagoda. Today, I'll be discussing about malnutrition in chronic kidney disease patients. So first, before discussing what is malnutrition in these patients and how it happens, I want to tell what kidney does and what are its functions and how these functions are related to malnutrition which will happen in these patients. So as we all know, we have two kidneys in our body, and the functions of the kidneys are broadly, it will maintain the water balance in our body, and it will excrete the excess of water, and it will remove the excess waste products from our body, and it will also maintain the acid-base balance. The excess acid which is produced during body metabolism, it is removed via kidneys. And it will also maintain the electrolytes. Electrolytes matlab sodium, potassium, calcium, phosphorus, all these are important for the body homeostasis, for the body to properly function. And these calcium, phosphorus, these are also important for the bone building. So in a way, kidney also helps for the bone health. And the excess amount of acid which is produced is excreted in the urine, and if kidney fails, this acid will get accumulated in the body. And the other functions of the kidneys are, it will also produce glucose, and it will also reabsorb the amino acids. Amino acids are the building blocks of proteins. So in the blood, whatever amino acids are there, they get generally filtered into the in the kidney from the blood, and the kidney will absorb more than 98% of them. Okay, so if there is any problem in the kidney, all these functions which I have told may get affected. Chronic kidney disease is defined as a problem in the structure or function of the kidney, and if it is present for more than 3 months. So what is the problem in structure? So we have two kidneys. Generally, they are of some specific size in people. From young age to adult age, there are different sizes of the kidneys which are normal. So if for that specific age, if the size of the kidney is small, or if the kidney has some scars, or if there are any cysts in the kidney, then this is the problem with structure. Function means, if there is a problem with structure, there may be a problem with function also. But if patient has a normal kidney size, a normal looking kidney, as such problem, there may be problem inside the kidney, which is a problem in the function. So the problems may be of two types. There will be structural problem and functional problem. If both of these are present for more than 3 months, then it is chronic kidney disease. So how to identify chronic kidney disease is by doing urine examination or by doing blood tests. In the urine, we can find that if the patient is leaking protein, or if there are any red blood cells in the urine, and if in the blood test, if the patient has raised urea and creatinine, all this will tell that patient has some problem with the kidney. And we know that there are 5 stages in the chronic kidney disease, stage 1 to stage 5. And this malnutrition in patients with chronic kidney disease generally is more prevalent once the patient enters the stage 3. Let's discuss about what type of malnutrition is seen in patients with chronic kidney disease. So the word malnutrition itself says that it is abnormal nutrition. So malnutrition can happen in a normal general terms when the patient has less intake of the nutrients or the nutrition. But in patients with chronic kidney disease, sometimes even though their nutrition is adequate, patient may end up in malnutrition. This is because of the mechanisms or the alterations in the body because of the kidney failure which will happen. And the type of malnutrition seen in these patients is protein energy wasting. So protein energy wasting means that there will be defect in the protein stores and also energy stores in the body. As we know that protein stores are predominantly muscle in the body, and energy stores are also decreased in these patients, and these patients are also at risk for nutrient deficiencies, like there may be deficiency of iron, multivitamins and electrolytes also. Kidney is important in excreting the excess acid which is produced in the body during metabolism. So if kidney fails, the acid gets accumulated. Excessive acid in the body is called acidosis. So acidosis which happens will lead to protein breakdown in the muscle. So once the protein in the muscle gets broken down, it will lead to muscle wasting, thinning of the muscles. Then one more thing which will happen in these patients with chronic kidney disease is change in the levels of hormones which modulate the appetite. Like there is abnormal levels of ghrelin and leptin. These are the hormones which generally are related to appetite in us. And if there is alteration in these hormones, they act on the brain and this will lead to reduced appetite. So reduced appetite in these patients will lead to reduced intake. So reduced intake, so somehow body has to maintain, body has its basal metabolic rate. For that to maintain, it requires some energy. So it will take from our own body. So the stores will be from the glucose, from the liver, kidney, and also from the muscle breakdown. So if the patient has less appetite, there will be muscle breakdown again. And energy stores will come down because they are used up by the body. And one more thing in these patients is there is increased basal metabolic rate in these patients. So if the patient takes less, it doesn't mean that the basal metabolic rate will go down. Here, compared to normal patients, in the kidney failure patients, the basal metabolic rate is high. So there is high requirement of energy at the basal levels. So because of the high basal metabolic rate, it will again lead to protein breakdown and protein wasting. So why it is important to identify protein energy wasting in these patients? So protein energy wasting is very, very important to identify because it will lead to poor quality of life in the patient. It can lead to heart problems, it can lead to increased infections, and it can also lead to less survival in these patients. So these are all very important outcomes for the patient, because if the patient, because of the protein energy malnutrition, if the patient stays alive for lesser duration, then it is a big problem. So how to identify protein energy malnutrition? Protein energy malnutrition can be identified by the nephrologist and the dietitian. They have their own scales. We have our own scales. Like there is a scale called Subjective Global Assessment and Malnutrition Inflammation Scale, in which there are few questionnaires. Along with that, we take the help of the lab tests like serum albumin and total iron binding capacity. With these tests, we will identify. But at the patient level, for a chronic kidney disease patient, if he wants to know whether he is having malnutrition or not, there are few signs. If the patient loses his body weight for more than 5% for the last 3 months, or if the loss is more than 10% in the last 6 months, it means that there is a problem with the malnutrition in the patient. Or if the patient's body mass index is going down, or if the patient's blood serum albumin is also low compared to the normal value of more than 3.5, if it is low consistently, and if the patient is losing weight and if his arm circumference is coming down, if he can see that his shirt or whatever body wear, it is becoming loose, or pant size is becoming loose, it means that patient is losing mass and there is malnutrition which is setting in. How the nutrition therapy helps in tackling this malnutrition? So malnutrition can be tackled by the nutrition therapy. Nutrition therapy will be given to the patient in association with both nephrologists and the dietitian. This is important because each patient is separate. Each patient has a separate cultural background, and they may be non-vegetarians, vegetarians, and their intake patterns may be different, and whatever their outlook for their life may be different, and whatever they are aiming from this disease may be different. So based on the patient preferences and association with nephrologists, because nephrologist will come into picture because he will look after the lab values, like what are the parameters in the blood which are suggestive of malnutrition and what are the targets for these specific patients, so that he will have best outcome. So in association with nephrologist and dietitian, a combined nutrition therapy for this each patient will be tailored. So how will the nutrition therapy help in patients with malnutrition and chronic kidney disease? Nutrition therapy has wide beneficial effects in patients with chronic kidney disease. So the first and the foremost thing is, if proper nutrition therapy is given, patient can come out of this malnutrition and they can have adequate nutrition, and we can prevent the occurrence of malnutrition. And the levels of electrolytes, which like sodium, potassium, calcium, phosphorus, which generally get deranged in these patients with the advancing of the chronic kidney disease, can be corrected with the nutrition therapy, and adequate bone health can be maintained. And the most important thing is, we can delay the progression of the chronic kidney disease in this patient. With adequate nutrition therapy, we can delay the disease progression. So we can slow down the kidney disease which is progressing in these patients. And nutrition therapy can also prevent the accumulation of acid in the blood. So all these are the beneficial effects of the nutrition therapy. First, as a general measure, what I want to tell is, for slowing of the kidney disease and to prevent the worsening of the kidney disease, and which is same thing, and to prevent the abnormalities, like prevent the acidosis or abnormalities of the electrolytes which happen in these patients, predominantly a plant-based diet is preferred in these patients compared to animal-based diet. This is because plant-based diet, on metabolism in the body, they produce base when compared to animal-based diet, like non-vegetarian and all. On the metabolism, on the breakdown in the body, they produce more of acid when compared to plant-based diet. So as I've already told, acid accumulation happens in kidney disease patient. If we further give acid, it will lead to more side effects in these patients, like there may be more problem with the bones and more worsening of the kidney disease. So predominant plant-based diet is preferred in chronic kidney disease patients. So coming to how much protein intake is advised in this patient per day. So this depends upon what stage of the patient, what stage of the chronic kidney disease is the patient in. So for example, if the patient may be non-dialysis dependent, another patient may be dialysis dependent. So the protein intake in these patients are different. So if the patient is non-dialysis dependent, matlab his creatinine is not very high and not dialysis requiring, then we'll restrict the protein in these patients. Average adult takes somewhere around 0.8 to 1 gram per kg per day protein. Here we need to restrict the protein to 0.6 to 0.8 gram per kg per day. So telling this value won't make any sense to the patient. So this here, the dietitian will come into the picture. So first we will, with the dietitian, we will see like what patient takes in a day based on their background. We will see how much protein is taking in a day from morning to night. And then if the patient is taking high amount of protein, we'll ask them to cut down, to bring down to 0.8 gram per kg per day. If they are taking very less, we'll ask them to take to 0.8 to 0.8 gram per kg per day. And the, as I've already told, plant-based diet is important in these patients. And one more thing is, in patients with dialysis, the protein intake is recommended to be taken little higher, from 1 to 1.2 gram per kg per day. This is because dialysis procedure as such will lead to protein loss, and also it is a catabolic state. Matlab, during dialysis procedures, there will be more muscle breakdown. It can lead to muscle breakdown in these patients because it will lead to inflammation. Dialysis procedure, it is a procedure in which blood is exposed to an external filter where the blood gets filtered. So this process will lead to increased inflammation and further muscle loss. So to prevent that, more amount of protein is advised in these patients of 1 to 1.2 gram per kg per day. And coming to how much calorie intake is advised in this patient, around 30 to 35 kilocalories per kg per day is advised, out of which carbohydrates we can give up to 50 to 60%, and fats should be less than 30%, and out of this fat, saturated fats, we should take less than 10%. And coming to sodium intake, the salt intake in these patients is very, very important. Higher salt intake of more than 5 grams will lead to body water retention, it can lead to hypertension, it can lead to heart disease. So, and it can also lead to worsening of the kidney disease. So lesser salt intake is advised in these patients. Lesser means it should be less than 5 grams per day. Salt intake of less than 5 grams per day included everything in 24 hours is advised in patients with chronic kidney disease. And coming to next one is the fiber intake. So fiber is very important in patients with chronic kidney disease. Around 25 grams of fiber per day is required for these patients. This is because fiber as such will prevent constipation in these patients, and fiber is also a source of raw material or the material on which the good bacteria in our gut feed on. So there are two types of bacteria in our intestines, good bacteria and bad bacteria. In patients with chronic kidney disease, the bad bacteria will increase and the good bacteria will decrease. The good bacteria requires this fiber, which is a complex polysaccharide on which they feed on, and they will produce some products which are beneficial to us, to our body, like it will strengthen our gut wall and it will prevent the complications. So if we take less of fiber, and as I've already told, the bad bacteria increases in the gut, the bad bacteria will produce the toxic products which will damage our intestines, and these toxic products will get absorbed into our blood, and this will lead to further heart problems and further worsening of the kidney disease. So these are all the general guidelines which are in relation to nutrition therapy in patients with chronic kidney disease.